Hello, YouTube, it's Steve. So, here is a kit that's not Gundam, but yet I still got it from the Gunpla God. I don't know what the hell is wrong with that entity, but yeah, he's been giving me a lot of non-Gunpla, but you know what? You make lemonade with lemons, so let's just go ahead and get cracking. So this thing is a Grandizer. I have absolutely no idea where it's from. Looks like it's the same exact box cover art as the Mazinger and the Great Mazinger from the Infinity movie. So I'm just kind of, throwing a little dart in the air and just assuming this is from the same kind of universe. I haven't seen the movie, and to be honest, I just don't care. I know he's pretty damn old, just as old as me, but regardless, I'm just not interested. But yeah, let's go ahead and start cracking this thing open. But first, if you want to get this kit, you can easily go to newtypehq.com, use that promo code Krosama, and you too can pick up this kit just like I did. So if you really are into this series, definitely get it. If you have no idea what this kit is and what it's about or what the series is about, I would recommend maybe stay tuned for the review and then make a decision after that. But regardless, you have the information. Do what you will with it. But yeah, let's finally get into the unboxing. So one of the main things I want to point out is that this thing does actually look pretty damn cool. I still don't give a shit about it, but you know what? Those horns kind of make it look pretty damn evil. And I know evil personally. So yeah, hopefully we can have some brewskis and just shoot the shit. We'll see. So this is a part of the high grade line, but honestly, this is like well above an actual high grade. It's very, very detailed, and it's going to come with a lot of cool little weapons and accessories. So yeah, I think this is more in terms of a master grade, but it doesn't really have the inner frame like most other kits in the master grade line does. This kit did come out in 2019, and the price point is roughly around $50 to $55. Here on the side of the box, you do get a pretty nice, decent picture of it. It looks like it is an unpainted version. I could be wrong, but I know these are fairly glossy and it's like bare plastic, so it looks unpainted. But regardless, it actually looks like a goddamn clown. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's just me. But it's a cool clown. Don't get me wrong. But yeah. And so here is all three of these Infinity type of designs. I mean, they're really awesome. They're much better than their old 80s or 70s counterpart. I think it's a significant upgrade with all the panels and kind of little gimmicks that it has. So yeah, it kind of fits in right with all of them. And here, if you want, you can read some of this little story. God damn it, there's actually more story. And here you have the double spazer, which is basically its backpack. And here you're going to have this like Sailor Moon looking weapon called the Single Harkins and the Double Harkins. Basically, it's like a lance, but it has a moon crest. I don't think it's that original, but it looks like it's probably effective. And in the center is going to be an anti-gravity storm. I'm pretty sure you could just chalk that up to probably a plot device. And to the left, you are going to have the Screw Crusher Punch, something that a 5-year-old probably named. And then to the right, you're going to have the Space Thunder. The head consists of intricate parts to recreate colored. Why is this even listed? What is Space Thunder? That doesn't tell me anything. Oh my god. And so there's going to be quite a few runners in here. Some are going to be from the Mazinger Z, but there are going to be a lot of new runners in here as well. So this is runner A. This is actually a brand new runner for this kit. You are going to see the clear red is going to be right there in the center. The white is fairly nice. It's kind of like almost a pearl gloss. And then you're going to have some clear parts on the top as well as some yellow. And so you're just going to have an all red runner, which has a little bit of the backpack, just some other little parts here and there. You got parts for the little gauntlets. But yeah, both of these are brand new runners for this kit. Now here you're going to have his runner C1, C2. These are actually borrowed from the Mazinger Z. But yeah, I think it's just going to be borrowing from some parts of like the legs as well as the torso. We'll definitely see though in the build. Runner D1 and D2, these are going to be brand new runners as well, but it's going to be a very high gloss black. Looks pretty damn good. I'm actually a little bit turned on by the level of details in this kit. You know, no homo and all, but goddamn, it looks sexy. And next is going to be runner E1 and E2. He's going to have a lot of the silver basically just riddled all over the kit. You are going to have those, like, moon crescent weapons. You know, it's a good silver. I actually really like the way it looks. It's pretty damn glossy as well. And next is going to be runner F1 and F2. These are basically going to be universal runners. I'm pretty sure for all three, because it doesn't explicitly state any of the kits. So they're probably just more generic inner frame stuff. Much like you see in Gunpla, where like it shares one frame with all the different types of kits within that universe. Much like the 00 series or even Iron Blood Orphans. But regardless, it's just a lot of inner frame stuff here. Next is going to be two Runner Gs, which is just going to be blue parts. Looks pretty good, has a good amount of detail in them as well, and very high gloss. And next is going to be two Runner Hs, which are going to be new runners as well. He's going to have the gauntlets and just some other little white parts all around. And next is going to be two Runner Is, so once again, new runners. But yeah, very much just going to be the yellow for the backpack. And the last runner is going to be runner J1 and J2. Yeah, just going to be, it looks like it's black, but has like maybe a hint of brown in it. It kind of, I don't know, but maybe a hint of blue. It's not like completely black. But regardless, there's going to be parts looking like for the legs, the arms, hands, and the little staff weapons, and just some other little parts here and there. Regardless though, looks really good. And you are going to have a sticker sheet, which mostly has just black all over it, a little bit of green, a little bit of blue, and a little white stripe. So, not to be confused with the band, obviously, but yeah, not really too bad of stickers. The black I could probably just color in with a Gundam marker. Green, I think I have a green Gundam marker, and white, well, I don't have one for that, so yeah, tough luck. And you are also going to get a stand with this kit. That is fantastic, and I'm pretty sure that's what raised this kit's price a little bit higher than what I've normally seen. I think the other ones came with a stand as well, but for what you're getting, I think this is actually a pretty damn good deal. It's a really good size, high grade, heavily detailed, and you get a stand all for around like $50. That's pretty damn good. So, yeah, bargain. And of course, lastly, we have the manual. Overall, I do think this is going to be a pretty interesting kit now that I'm seeing the runners. I still have no idea who this guy is, but if he's pretty damn powerful, even though he's looking like a complete clown, I'll gladly accept him in my ranks. So, other than that, guys, definitely appreciate all of you for watching, and let me know what you think in the comment section below. But, like always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.